Hi there, back at the workbench again. I had a good response to the video on how to replace Suzuki welded harmonica reeds on a diatonic harmonica, and I had a few questions about whether it's the same process on chromatic harmonicas, as well as other questions on, you know, what happens if things go a little bit wrong, and how do you, you know, sort out little issues that might arise. So I'm making this video, actually two videos, on how to replace a welded reed on a chromatic harmonica, and I'm going to include various little tricks and tweaks along the way, which is why it needs to be in two videos rather than one. When you're actually replacing the reed, you can do it in pretty much the same amount of time as the diatonic reed. A little bit longer because there's a valve involved as well, anyway, as I say, these two videos will include various extra information which you might find useful. Okay, well, here we have a Suzuki chromatic harmonica reed plate. This is one from a 12-hole chromatic, the SCX48, and you can see that the reeds are welded on in exactly the same way as for the diatonic harmonicas. Okay, now you can also see those little white strips there. Well, those of course are the wind savers or the valves. So the first thing to do when you're working on replacing a reed is to remove the wind saver on the opposite side of the reed that you're going to work on. I don't actually have a reed plate with a broken reed, so basically I'm going to take one of these good reeds off and then just replace it, just to kind of show you what's going on. So we'll just pick some reed at random, maybe that one there. Okay, so basically this one here has got a wind saver on the other side of it, so the first thing to do is remove that, and I just put a blade underneath it, put my thumb on the wind saver and just pull it off like that. Okay. And we'll just keep that aside for later. We can replace it. Now you'll see there's a little bit of glue residue left here. You can just basically scrape that off with your blade. Later on we'll tidy that up a bit more when we come to re-glue the valve. Okay, so that reed there now has no valve on the other side. Now, if we want to replace that reed, we assuming it's broken, we do the same as we did with the diatonic, and basically we just wrench the reed off with the Suzuki reed wrench. Just be careful of the valves on either side. But anyway, there's the reed come away now, and it's you can see the slot is there. Okay, so the first thing to do is tidy up the surfaces of the reed and the slot. There's a very tiny little disturbance on the surfaces. I'm just using my little... if you want to pick up a reed, by the way, just do anything small, just wet your finger and it'll pick up. So I'm going to just tidy up the base of this little reed here. Doesn't take much, just to smooth the surfaces, make them level. Okay, the next thing to do is to tape the reed in place, ready for drilling. So now I'm just putting that reed in place. It's a bit of a slightly delicate operation. Just make sure it's sitting there in there and reaching the end. So now taping that in there, taping the valves. We have to be careful when we remove the tape later on to make sure the valves don't come off. But I'll demonstrate that. Okay, so the reed's in place now, and as before, it's ready for drilling. Okay, now we're ready to drill the initial hole through the reed and the reed plate. It's actually a 1.2 millimeter drill, and I'll put the imperial measurement of that up on the website. Okay, so here's our 1.2 millimeter drill, Now we just need to do as before, drill through the base of the reed, the what we used to call the rivet pad, very carefully, and it needs to go right through both the reed and the reed blade in one hit. Okay. So there we go. Now this is a little bit tricky because we don't want to pull off the wind savers. So as I'm pulling this tape off, I'm pulling from the base of the wind savers. If I pulled from the other direction, they'd probably pull off. So I've got them sort of largely off now, and the wind savers have stayed there, and the reed is still on the tape. Okay, so now just keep it intact and tape it back onto your piece of wood. Things with, when you're working with chromatics, it's always a little bit more of a delicate operation than with diatonics, just because there's more bits to watch out for, more things to go wrong. Okay, so now we take our 1.4, or we remove this drill bit. That's the 1.2. I'm just stressing that because I got it wrong last time. And here we go, this is the number, the 1.4 mil. Okay, and we want to do the same as we did with the diatonic reed. We want to go directly, put the 1.4 bit into the hole and through the base of the reed. Okay, very simple. And remove the tape and move back to the workbench. Okay, so as with the diatonic reed plate, we've got the reed, which is still attached to the tape. We want to remove that very carefully. Get rid of the tape. So the reed now has a 1.4 mil hole, and the reed plate a 1.2 mil hole. Just tidy up those surfaces again. I like the rubber polishing wheel because it's very precise, and it takes off very little metal. Okay, now as we did before, just ream the hole slightly to accept the screw, and we're nearly ready to go. Okay, now what we did before was simply to put the reed in place. But there's a couple of little tricks you can do to kind of make it ensure that the reed is really centered in the slot. See, I've just cut a tiny bit of tissue paper there. And what you can do, if you want to, personally I don't really do this because it's a little bit time consuming, and I find it's just as quick to jiggle things around if there's any issue. But basically, you can press the reed into place in the slot, and the paper will create, will make sure that there is a totally even clearance around the whole reed. You can see the way it's pushed in there like that now. Okay, so now we get our screwdriver, and with the, you can see the little screw on the end there. I'll just pull them apart just so you can see the bits. You can see it there, and I'm just putting it on the end of the screwdriver. And now the thing is to tap it into the reed plate. This time I'm just going to hold the reed plate on the table, and just because it's being held in place nicely by the paper, just slowly tap the screw in. I won't tighten it up all the way now, but hopefully, because the paper has ensured that the reed is correctly, there's equal clearance around all sides of the reed and the front, it should be perfectly fine now. So basically, you just move your, turn the reed plate over, pop it out like that, pull the paper off, and, you know, if we're lucky, the reed will play straight away.